What's up, everybody? Sorry about the small delay there in the intro, but today I'm going to be casting Luzaruha Gaming versus Totem Stetlin Incorporated. I'm just going to call them TS Incorporated like they are on the overlay. So, catching up here on Picks and Bans, we have the Outworld Devourer. I call him Outworld Destroyer. So he's banned out. He's probably one of the best mid heroes in the game. Alchemist being banned out as well for the Radiant side. Or for LZH. Weaver and Batrider banned for Dire. So the Visage has been picked up as a first pick. He's a really big first pick because of his versatility, and he's probably one of the best supports in the entire game. Nyx Assassin being picked up here for TS Inc. And I wonder what their second hero is going to be. Io is still open, so is Keeper of the Light. A lot of other heroes are still open. Or could they take that Razor? Razor's been one of those big picks lately. Also, this is the version where Elder Titan. Oh god, I had a brain fart. Elder Titan, Centaur, Warrunner. Two more Troll, Warlord, and. It'll come to me. Oh, Abaddon. They're all enabled for this patch, so you know that this game is definitely the latest patch. Taking up some of that reserve time here, so to really think about it, Keeper of the Light has been picked up. For TS Inc. Now another pick here for LZH. Io is still in the pool. Maybe this may not be the game for him, but Io is still open. I wonder if they can pick him up, or maybe they pick up their carry here or their mid. So this game is actually one of those team matchmaking games that I thought was cool. Nature's Prophet being picked up, another strong pick. Literally won championships, aka TI3. But anyway, this is one of those team matchmaking games that you kind of see. You take five, go in, queue up, and play against another team of five. It's not like regular matchmaking, but this is team matchmaking, aka it's going to be default to Captain's Mode. So I don't know too much about this TS Incorporated team. Other than that, they're Dire side, and it seems like their picks are from maybe a meta game ago. I don't know if they've been keeping up with TI3. Darkseer banned out here, one of the better offlaners in the entire game, as well as TA banned out here from the Dire side. Puck banned, one of the best mids. Man, they're picking and banning really fast. I have to keep up. So LZH Gaming, they were another name. Episodic used to play quite a bit competitively. I remember FK, Hyorin, and Loudmetal from other teams much before this one. I think they were all in the Sunday Evening Cup series. Episodic was IO banned here, out. Actually, surprised he didn't get picked up. Clockwork picked up immediately by Toten. But anyway, Episodic used to play for another team. He played in a lot of tournaments that I held, especially the qualifier for the Pro Dota 2 League. And I also believe that he played in the ECAL Americas qualifier, or in the tournament itself. Gyrocopter picked up here by LZH. So Luzaruha Gaming is a very, very, very storied organization. I think they used to have a WoW guild. I think that's what they were prominent for. And they used to have a StarCraft 2 team. I believe, if I remember correctly, Shinya, Fiery, and Fantasy were all on the team. They're all really good players. I think they all play for Quantic now on their academy team. So they were on MYI for a while, My Intent. And now they're playing for Quantic. This isn't the first time that LZH has delved into Dota 2. I believe that they were in negotiations with Brax's old team, and then Brax ended up going to another team, or going to Quantic to go ring for them. Sorry if you hear the sniffling, by the way. So, fourth pick. Alright, so it was pretty much a PL setup here with the Caudle and Nyx Assassin. But they should be able to stop this. if they pick the right support for this. I believe that the Nature's Prophet and the Gyrocopter are really good picks. The Visage is also really good. The Visage could be the dust carrier for the rest of the game. But I think this is definitely going to be a support pick here. Because they would have to complete the tri-lane for the Gyrocopter. And they can always take the mid at any time. So if it's a DK... Is it DK or Razor? Mid, then... Okay, so they take the Naga Siren. That's going to be a support Naga Siren. Which leads me to believe that it could be a Razor mid. Or a DK. Because I don't think they have a mid hero yet. Unless the Gyrocopter goes mid. But I'm pretty sure it's going to be a tri-lane. Either way. Then Nature's Prophet is probably going to be in the offlane. And it'll be PL Caudal Nyx on the safe, Clockwork off. And then I don't know who their mid is going to be. There's going to be a... It'd be quite interesting to see. So Doom banned out here. Doom has been quite the pick in some of these in-house leagues. I've been watching them quite closely, but a lot of those in-house leagues are like just for fun. Timbersaw being banned out here, so they do pick up the Storm Spirit. That's going to be their mid hero. Timbersaw is one of the better mids as well. Coming up. Reactive armor on him is really, really good. So this has to be the mid for LZH. For Doom, if they decided to jungle him, it would work. It would be pretty good. 10 seconds remaining. Because of the silence and all of that. And he also gets a lot of bonuses from those neutral creeps. But I don't think it was ban worthy. I think they should have just banned another mid. So SF is open. Razor is open. DK is open. Well, those are three I can think of at the moment. Unless they do something crazy and go a Necrolite, but I don't think this is a Necrolite game. The other thing as well is the Earthshaker has been picked up quite a bit just to do that ancient pulling in the middle lane for Radiant. Oh, okay, so they pick up the DK. I feel comfortable with it. Episodic going to be on that Naga Siren. And we're going to get into this game momentarily. So it'll be Luz Ruha Gaming versus Totem Stehlin Incorporated. Interesting team name on the Dire side. Guys got a... Stop being AFK and come back. Come back. So I guess just introducing the players a little bit. It'll be Popeye's Wolfdrake on a Nyx Assassin. Oops. Forgot to adjust the camera. So it'll be Popeye's Wolfdrake on a Nyx Assassin, Fury on the Clockwork, Crystyle on PL, Woe on the Caudal, and Amu on the Storm Spirit. Meanwhile, on the Radiant side, we have Episodic on Naga Siren, going to be placing some wards. FK on the Dragon Knight, going bottom now, going to be Visage, or Loud Metal on the Visage, Heorin on the Gyrocopter, and Jeeves on a Nature's Prophet. A nice courier, by the way. Both these teams, very nice couriers. I believe this one is from the Star Ladder, and this one is the Winchell from the Premier League. So there's two Treants going to be scouting out here for the runes on both sides on the map. Epizodic is going to be securing a ward placement, possibly over here, so that his mid hero can see this part and see where that other hero is at. So there you go. You can kind of see the outline and see that he can see what he can see. And it's a regen rune, so Epizodic will pick that up. Did he get the... I didn't see if he got the better block off. There's a way to make a really good block if you block off the left side. Like over here, and then they go right. Like, all the creeps have to go right, so you block it off, but not sure if he did. Oh, interestingly enough, it's not an offlane profit. They've left the offlane completely open. So even though the PL is farming, they're giving the chance for the Nature's Prophet to farm the jungle. Because if the Dire makes the mistake of pushing down the Radiant Tower, then the farm will be on the Radiant side. And even though you don't want to lose a tower, this is probably one of the most unimportant towers in the entire game. Another thing is, this ward is used to see what the Clockwork is doing. What the Clockwork could do is go up here, and if he picked the cogs, it doesn't look like he's skilled up anything yet. So he can put up the cogs. Oh, is he going to do it? No, he didn't. So you cogs here, and then you open it up so the creeps go this way. And then the other creeps go to your tower. But since Epizodic has opened up the tree line here to take the creeps to the neutral, to the second level, so it looks like Naga Siren is going to be playing the hard support this game. Well, Visage has the smoke, so once they pass the Gandalf, that's what we're gonna call it. So once they pass the Gandalf, they can go in and gank anybody they want. The Clockwork is gonna be back for a while, so he's not gonna be doing much. So let's put up the last hits. Is it gonna be 9-2? 9-3. So it's a free lane for this Gyrocopter as well as it is for the PL. But like I said, they cannot make the mistake of trying to push in. So they got the ward, dewarding already. A level 1, really nice ward. Okay, so he used the Static Remnant to pretty much see where the Naga Siren is going. So let's take it here for the Dragonite. So Dragonite has skilled up his Dragon Tail. If they decide to go on him, he's not going to be able to escape. So it's a net, it's a stun, that's going to be a first blood. It's going to be good to Dragonite, they give it to the Dragonite. So DK with the first blood, he's going to win the lane. Now there's going to be a bigger opportunity for the DK to farm any item he wants. I think he just got his bottle, but we're going to check on him in a bit. We have Nature's Prophet still farming that jungle. He's dewarded, very nice sentry ward here. A Loud Metal is farming on this Visage. Visage, Visage, doesn't matter. I've heard it pronounced both ways. So Epizodic going to be pulling. So the pull is successful. And the Clockwork is level 2. He's got the Rocket going on. Rocket will hit. It'll damage the Dragonite a little bit. But not so much. It's 6-4. And DK is 12-5. If they get another kill over there, definitely the Radiant will be in a better spot. If they let the PL farm too much, then the Dire will win. So if the Dire decides to take this to a late game, they have a better shot. Because the item build for PL will be insane. So he's got almost 1500 gold. On this Gyrocopter. Gyrocopter is level 5 compared to 2. Oh man, that's gonna be tough, especially if it's an early BKB. So as you can see, they passed the Gandalf. And now they're gonna be going in for another kill. So they're gonna be attempting to dive on the Clockwork. Is it going to work? Are they gonna go in? They have to go in. So he goes in, he's gonna initiate with the Riptide and the net. And that's gonna be all she wrote for this Clockwork, and that's that kill is going episodic. I noticed that he hesitated a little bit because he didn't want to take that kill. He wanted his gyrocopter to take it, but at this point, it's okay. So they can push down this tower if they want and get a lot of gold for it. Meanwhile, these two guys are just going to be stacking and jungling for the rest of the game because they can't push the tier 1 top tower, at least not right now. The Nature's Prophet will teleport up there and do something about it. I thought there was going to be another kill. So we do see a teleport from the Nature's Prophet. $2,000 gold on this PL. He's got 34 last hits. And that was a nuke onto that Nature's Prophet, so PL is level 6. He's farming quite well. He's got a Tranquil Boots, which will help his sustainability in the lane. 2,000 gold on this Gyrocopter. DK with a double damage rune. Going to probably go after the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit can easily get out of that. So even though he'll be stunned, it won't be enough damage. But he had the right presence of mind to just move back. So more creep pulling and jungling. Caudal Heart support, looks like. Oh, he's got a Blade of Alacrity. So he's going to be going the Purge Stick first. I mean, Diffusal Blade. I tend to call things by different nicknames. So I hope I don't get killed for that. Nuke, the Lance going onto the Prophet, doing quite a bit of damage, that image is. A Caudal Stack. So it's a level 7, but is he going to go for him? Oh my god, I think he is. He's going to go for him. Oh my god, that's going to be a solo kill for this PL. Is he going to get him? Yeah, he should. He's got the mana. PL got him. He tried to tree him out so he could run away. It was a good shot. Uh-oh. DK TPing up. He's got... Oh my god, I think he's going to get the kill. That's a big... That's two kills for the DK. And that's going to put him closer to another big item. So he's got treads in his bottle. Mana burn going down on the DK. He's got 5 mana. Oh, is there a reaction? Nope. It doesn't have enough mana to do it. I noticed that he's trying to fake his... Oh, here we go. Trying to fake the teleport. They let the Gyrocopter get the tower. It's a very nice move. It let him get his Helm of the Dominator. So what he's going to do is take a creep from the forest, a neutral creep, and stack ancients, and then farm them up with the Fly Cannon Rocket Barrage, as well as the regular attack. I think if this Naga Siren is going to build that, I think she's going to be going Urn and Medallion, which are the two bigger items. Because if she's buying wards all day, it's obvious that she's not going to have those, have very good items, but Medallion is a relatively cheap item, and Urn is really good. You can hurt somebody, and you can heal somebody. So it looks like he's already done it. So you can see that he took a neutral from the forest, sent it up here to start stacking ages. I can't believe I didn't notice this before, but it's going to be big later on when he has to farm his BKB, if that's the item he's going next. So 3-1 in favor of LZH. Prophet with the Hand of Midas. Going to be on money on money. But it's going to be action mid. Is there action? Oh, okay, there's a stun. The Storm Fury is going in. Can he get it done? They should get a kill here. No kill, but they're going to probably get this Naga Siren. That's going to be one right click and he's done. No backup there. There's absolutely nobody. Can't blame him. He didn't even have his ult yet, so if he wanted to ult, if he had ult, he probably would have used it. But anyways, 3-2. And the tower war is still in favor of the Radiant. So he's getting closer and closer to Purge Stick. The Prophet's going to have to hold his own here to defend his tower. Not too much going on as of this moment. Hero level, the DK, highest level in the game. Clockwork with the most gold in the game. Or, I mean, well, currently. It's probably going to be going Mana Boots, if anything. So your Mana Boots on the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit should be going a Silent Stick, aka Orchid Malevolence. I call it a Silent Stick. Okay, so it looks like we're going to have a big engagement. Stone going down onto the Visage. They do get the kill on the Nyx Assassin, and they're going to pull back for a little bit. So the Wrath of Nature hit, and I think the Prophet got stunned. The rest of his team just cleaned up the Nyx Assassin, and they're going to be trying to go for another hero kill. Not sure if it's going to happen. It's pretty much the siege on the top one Dire side. So more support coming in for Dire. The Storm Spirit is up top now. Can they get it done? No, the Cuddle will hold him off. Oh my god, he's gonna be going in. But nice reaction time on that stun and net. And Radiant forced to back off. Heorin, the hero with the most denies, and the kind of second most farm in the game. The ultimate first part misses, but the second one will hit. And does Nyx Assassin should go down? No, he's actually outside of it. But oh my god, a lot of things are going on. The Riptide and the right click from the Naga Siren hitting him. The Visage did get the kill earlier with the Soul Assumption. A nice sentry placement in case the Nyx Assassin decided to go in. And I believe they have enough to take the tower. Are these familiars going to stun? The familiars do get the stun down. No follow-ups though. So Dire still defends the tower, but they lose a couple of heroes for it. And Visage is one step closer to his mechanism. Well, Epizodic actually has his urn. The DK will be going back mid. It looks like he's going to be going for a Shadow Blade with the Claymore. And I don't know what item Prophet is going to be going. Oh, okay, so he's got a buckler. He just needs a recipe. This guy is just going to be buying some wards. So there you go, he's got some wards. The PL has his Diffusal Blade now. And Nyx has his own Mana Boots. Oh my god, I think he's gonna get the kill. The Clockwork got the kill, really nice. Really nice play. 6-3 in favor of LZH. So the nuke from the PL hit, and the image was doing enough damage. But this Clockwork, oh my god, the Clockwork actually hit the DK. I think the Visage should go down to this. Song of the Siren used by the Naga Siren, but a little too late. And Naga Siren will go down. But the Gyrocopter is coming in. Can he get it done? The PL will live. Barely. And the stun will go down onto this Nyx Assassin, and he's done. The Gyrocopter will pick up that kill. And that's his first kill of the game. So the Prophet comes up and tries to clean up house. And it looks like it should be tower. They do have a glyph, and they're going to use it here, but it won't matter because this tower is just going to melt once the glyph expires. And another tower kill for this gyrocopter, who is inches and inches closer to his BKB. Shadowblade coming out for the DK after that kill. 600 more gold for this Visage's Mechanism. And he's also going for a Shadowblade. So the Gyro will go back to farming. This guy will continue to stack Ancients. And looks like we've got action mid. Is this going to be a dead Clockwork? It will be. Soul Assumption doing a lot of work there. Is this going to be a stun? He gets a stun, but it's outside of the ward range. And that's going to end it. At least end the skirmish. And we go back to farming. So you have to really pay. Oh my god. The Nature's Prophet is going to die to the PL. The Naga can't do much about it. Good net, but just not enough mana, and he should go down. Oh, no. Well, maybe. No, the Naga will live. And we missed one. So while that was happening, looks like it was a stun, and the Storm Spear just vaulting in there and getting that kill. So I thought it was going to be a kill on the Naga Siren, but it ended up not happening. It's too many kills sometimes, and you can't track them all. So 8-7. Favor of LZH, but TS Incorporated is coming back. He's getting closer to Mechanism. And he's just buying the ward. So they get the Illuminate down onto the Centaur creep. And that's pretty big. Because it means that there's nobody here to stack the Ancients anymore for this Gyrocopter to farm. And they saw the stacks. They saw the stack. But they can't do anything about it. Now I think about it, it doesn't even have to be Gyrocopter stack, even though it most likely will be him farming it, but this DK could get it as well. Some people like to level stun, but it looks like we have a pause. So people like to level up stun, and the more you level it, the longer it is, for probably 0.25 seconds, if you look. But it's one of the longest stuns at level 1 in the game. I think the only thing that's longer is Putnam's Arrow, or Mirana's Arrow. Or possibly the Alchemist stun. So no mirror images yet. Doesn't want to pick him up. He decided to max out the Riptide and get the net second and then pick up his ult when he could. So he's been warding and he has an Urn of Shadows. I think that's pretty big for the support to be getting that kind of item early. But if he picks up a Medallion, I think LZH will be in a much better place because they can just minus armor probably the Storm Spirit. And the Storm Spirit will just blow up to right clicks. Because if you look at the lineup for the Radiant side, the right clicks are pretty heavy. So let's look at some graphs, because I know people like graphs. Gold difference, favor of LZH. EXP was on the peak for LZH, but it looks like they've picked back up in the recent fight. And throughout the game, so that's your graphs. I don't know, I don't like using the graphs personally, but I guess if people like them, we gotta use them. So one pause coming out. And some dewarding. So it looks like they're gonna be diving this gyrocopter, and he's done. Ain't nobody stopping that. Nice cancel on the TV. I think that was a smart decision. The Knicks had a stun up, so that dude would have died. So Invis Rune on this Dragonite, and the Naga Siren will be following him in. So nice stun, that's gonna be one dead PL. Is it gonna be one dead PL? No, he actually... What? Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Oh, he revealed himself and died to creeps. Just wasn't enough. Man, that thing can't last forever. But in the meantime, Radiant will finally lose one tower, and it'll be at the bottom one. Storm's here, I guess that one. Oh, we haven't looked at his items yet. So Oblivious F, he's probably going to be getting... Why did I hesitate on this? It's a silent stick, Orc and Malevolence. So let's look at items. I don't know what this guy is going to be getting, but I think the game is going to rely on him to farm something good. PL's getting some pretty good items. Let's look at LZH. We've looked at LZH quite a bit. Mechanism for the Visage. I think he's had it for a while. And Gyrocopter. Oh, I'm surprised he hasn't had his BKB yet. Actually. Thought he was going to have BKB a lot sooner, but it isn't always the case. And a little bit closer to those Shadow... Shadow Blade. Wouldn't be surprised if this guy also farmed a BKB. So they passed the Gandalf middle, and now they're going to be hunting for heroes. See if they can get anybody. Oh, these guys know. That they're smoked up. Smoke's about to wear off. So smoke is done. They didn't get anything out of it. And now they're going to have to be back a little bit more. They do get the wards down. But not gonna be. Nah, nothing eventful will happen. Two of these guys farming bottom. Now, if anything, I don't think. Let's see, they're. Okay, so their wards are on cooldown, but. It looked to me like if they warded around where the PL was farming, which they did for a little bit, oh, we've got action. I think this is one dead DK, unless a miracle happens and he gets out. Stun's a little bit late, but I don't think it mattered because that dude was dead. Tied game. Tied game. And it's possibly a tower unless they fortify and defend. Like a Naga Siren. A little bit. Wrath going down. That's gonna stop it temporarily, but they do get that tower and they're not gonna fortify for it. So he has BKB and 1500 gold. Cuddle has his mechanism now. Orc of Malevolence coming out here from Storm Spirit. Going to be interesting. And I want to see if PL has another eye. Oh! Is he trying to buy Radiant straight up? That's so risky. Gets a Sacred Relic right now. It's 60 damage. There are some heroes you get it on and some heroes you don't get it on, but in this case, PL might as well get it if he's going to save up that much gold. His team isn't here. Riptide is going down, along with the Wrath of Nature. Storm Spirit putting on Jordan's to hop two steps and top back. Nature's Prophet does pick up the Phantomizer, but the song misses. They're just going to be going for this tower instead. And that's actually a big kill on the PL. Sun going down here on the Gyrocopter. Will they get him? I think they do. BKB actually. What? McKenzie healing up this Gyrocopter. And this Gyrocopter is huge. He's got the BKB on and the Storm trying to Michael Jackson his way out of this one, but it's not going to happen. Visage getting a double kill. A triple kill coming out here from Visage. Visage playing really well. Nature's Prophet. I thought that the Gyrocopter is going to get that kill, but Visage with the familiars and everything. He's been playing well this game, actually. I think he's played well. So is the Naga Siren. I think the support's played really well. On LZH. I think if they're going to make it big in some tournaments, some of these guys, I think they have the potential to play in a lot of tournaments. Oh, besides that, gotta stop Nyx Assassin try to go for the jugular, but it wasn't gonna happen. But instead, Caudle's just going to blast him away. But this is one dead Storm Spirit. Soul Assumption is way too good. 16 to 10, favor of Radiant. I believe this game is over because the Prophet is farming top. So even though the Naga Siren dies, it just buys a lot more time for the Prophet to just farm top and win and take out towers. So the PL did get that kill, which is pretty big for them still. But he's got 4,400 gold. You know, buy a Radiant straight up. Book of Necromicon. Oh, this is a smart choice. So you know there's a lot of Invis heroes, and if you keep upgrading it, you get the True Sight. And it does more damage. Nice chain stun. Even though nothing to follow up, but at least a chain stun was cool. ...26 minutes in with 27 kills. The game finally picked up. So anyway, LZH is supposed to be the next North American team to play in the tournaments like the Premier League, the Defense. Whenever the Sunday Evening Cup Series Reloaded comes back. And some of these other tournaments, these guys are supposed to be the next team to make the run. I don't blame them for trying for TI4. If you watched TI3 and you saw that team get 1.4 mil, man. I try it too. Manta style coming out here from PL. That was a Manta straight up. More farming on the Gyrocopter. He's got almost 3,800 gold. What do you buy next? Smoke coming for Nyx Assassin. Gonna try something. He's getting butterfly. Looks like this guy is going scepter in pieces. Same null talisman from minute 8. Prophet just farming. It's right click Dota. It's a different era. like how Dota has evolved throughout the years. This game has been out for... Dota 2 has been out for a couple of years now, but Dota 1... Man, I really liked how the game has evolved. So they're now going down here on... to the next assassin. That guy is going to get blown up. The clockwork should get blown up as well. Keeper of the Light does kill the Naga Siren, but it's just too much damage for that PL to handle. Visage playing incredibly well. He finally gets his Wicked ended streak, but Yoren will now get a double kill on his Gyro. That should be the tower. Oh, but backdoor protection. And bottom has been taken. Oh, you gotta control your... control these guys to kill the Rax. Well, he took the more important Rax, which is fine. Dire's bottom barracks are under attack. The regen on these familiars. It was a good shot. Storm Spirit blowing up this gyrocopter. Now they're going to be going on to this prophet. They have eyes? Yep. They have eyes. No mana though. This guy just needs to run a little bit faster. Oh, he's not going to die. Oh my god, it's going to be the comeback of the year. The Prophet is about to just nail him with the Necromicon summons. Well, meanwhile, this Visage is just going to solo this. Yeah, that's game. So there you go, that's going to be game. GG. LZH played well. I think the supports played really well this game. Really liked it. So that's gonna end it. And there's your source screen. So thank you guys for watching.